Maya, un favor de ti. Sorry, she looks beautiful.
Thank you, thank you.
Oh, look at me.
Okay, what time
is it? That's fine. Good with that.
Oh, Bobby. Maya,
is that mine?
No, hey, not the hair, the hips. Grab the hips.
Sorry, guys. She's like, sorry, guys.
Welcome our first beautiful bride, escorted by her sister.
It was you when we first met us. It was you in the city lights. It was you when I almost lost control. It was you through the darkest times. It was you that would make me shine. It was you that I hold on tight. It's always been you.
And who supports this woman as she unites her life and marriage today? And now, our second beautiful bride, being escorted by her padre.
One look at you, my whole life falls in line. I prayed for you.
You may be seated.
Yes,
I know. Yeah.
Hi, ladies. Welcome to the day that you've dreamed of, your wedding day. And welcome, family and friends. Today's a celebration. It's a celebration of love, of commitment, of friendship, and of family, and of these two people who are in it forever. Now, most of you have traveled quite a distance to offer your love and your support for this union. Farah and Dyrene would like to thank each and every one of you for taking the time to be here and witness their joy. They consider themselves so blessed to have such a rich, diversely blended group of family and friends. There are no limits to the love, comfort, and support that you've offered them on their best and their worst days. Your presence is so appreciated. If you would, let's pray together. Lord, our hearts are filled with great happiness on Farah and Dyrene's wedding day as they come before you, pledging their hearts and their lives to one another. Father, grant that they may always be true and loving. Help them to remember to be one another's sweetheart, helpmate, and friend, so that together they can meet the cares and the problems of life more bravely. Temper their hearts, Father, with kindness and understanding, and help them to parent Reeves and teach him through example. Father, bless this union and make their home a place of joy and peace. Amen. Now, you don't have to have a ceremony to have a wedding or a marriage. It's kind of weird, isn't it? Yep. I mean, the two of you are standing here all dressed up, looking really fancy, and being stared at by pretty much everyone that's ever meant anything to you. So why this moment? Because in spite of all of our differences, love is the one thing that we share. It's our great unifier, our one universal truth. No matter who we are, where we've come from, what we believe, we know this one thing. Love is what we're doing right. And that's why the two of you are standing here. Now, each of us has a love story, but this is your love story, and it all began about 5 years ago when you met through work. Farah, you were a bit surprised at this amazing coworker who offered to pitch in and help with a project. You weren't really sure about her abilities, so you asked her, do you know how to use a drill? Well, that was the beginning. You took the time to get to know one another, to figure out what makes one another laugh, how to best support each other on your less than simple days. You've traveled the world, and boy, that's a great test for any relationship. You've bought a house, and you're making it your home. Together with your good friend, Mike. Thanks, Mike. You've built this fabulous wedding structure that will become an important addition to your backyard. You love going to the pool, attending live music events, and hanging with your huge circle of friends. While on the surface, the two of you might seem to be very opposite, those differences are exactly what make you such a great team. Dyrene, you have accepted the challenge of being a bonus mom to Reeves, and you're crushing it. Of course, neither of you really knew where this relationship would take you. You've come a long way since those days, and you've learned that patience and communication are the keys to success. True love has a foundation of friendship. It's being with that one person who makes you feel your truest self, who inspires you to grow for the better. Marriage must always include the important combination of comfort and passion. At times you've felt like it's been a real roller coaster ride, screaming surprise and delight when you successfully negotiate complicated times and coming through better than when you began. You've faced some challenges and some struggles. You've grown individually and together, and you've done it side by side. Still, we all know love isn't always perfect, is it? It's not always glitter, rainbows, and unicorns. It's overcoming obstacles, facing challenges, fighting to be together, holding on, and never letting go. You each have already put in a lot of hard work to make this relationship not just last, but flourish, and you need to continue to do so. Irene, I feel like I've known you for years, girl. Seriously, you are a super organizer and yet a soft-spoken, outgoing personality. You know exactly what you want, and you don't hesitate to make a plan to achieve it. Plus, you can sit back and appreciate when your hard work pays off. You are Farrah's hype girl and her supporter. She needs that because at times she doesn't realize just how accomplished she is. Farrah. You are that quiet soul who thinks and acts with intention. You're so patient. While not quite as bubbly as Dee, you put others at ease with that smile. Yeah, that's the one. You always look for ways to put other people first. And that's probably why you just recently received that pineapple award, isn't it? Tyreen loves that you make her feel secure. And thank goodness you can cook. Dee would still be living on granola bars and DoorDash. Your relationship began the moment you met, and you did know how to use a drill. You've taken the time to welcome one another's families, communities, and friends, and you've joined them together with warmth and enthusiasm. Today's just a reminder of what your love's already accomplished and the amazing possibilities, what it can continue to accomplish and overcome in the many, many decades ahead of you. So with this in mind, are each of you here willingly and prepared to devote the rest of your life to this person whose hand you now hold? Last chance, it's gonna get real.
Yes.
I didn't hear you.
Yes.
Tyreen, do you accept Farrah as your best friend and your wife, vowing to love and cherish her in sickness and in health, through good times and bad, and to be faithful to her until death parts you?
I do.
Farrah, do you accept Tyreen as your best friend and your wife, vowing to love and cherish her in sickness and health, through good times and bad, and to be faithful to her until death parts you?
I do.
Now, each of you have spent quite a bit of time and thought creating personal words for one another. Farrah, I'm going to ask you to go first.
Need you to focus.
have loved you for 5 years now, but have longed for you my entire life. I knew when we first met that you were someone special, but only time would tell that you were and still are my saving grace. I am so thankful that you did not count me out despite every situation that we've been through. You have been and will always be my light at the end of every day. You have been my biggest supporter through moments it probably would have benefited you more to just walk away. You've held me through the hurt, always have made me feel special. Loved, heard, seen, and safe. You teach me every day how to be a better person, and that stepping out of your comfort zone is really where life begins. I'll never forget the time you wanted me to step out onto a glass ledge 103 floors up off of the third largest building in the Western Hemisphere. It took you a lot of convincing and time for my legs to move forward when my mind was literally telling me that I was about to die. The entire line got a good laugh at my repetitive okays, as I believe I said it about 1,000 times before stepping foot on the glass. I finally did it, only to be instructed to step out further for a picture. Oh boy, was I sweating. After that experience, I have never felt more alive. Because of you, Dairene Falcon, I have lived the best days of my life. And it is my honor and privilege to get to spend the rest of my days with you. Today, in front of our family and friends, I promise to you, the biggest dreamer, the hardest hustler, my free-spirited celebrator of life, my boundary-drawing protector, and the one who loves me unconditionally. To persevere when times get tough, knowing that any challenges we might face, we will conquer them together. I promise to nurture your goals and ambitions, to support you through misfortune, and to celebrate your triumphs. I promise to love our future children unconditionally and to provide them with the best life that life has to offer. I promise to help you remain consistent in what you hope can be a routine. I promise to choose you every day. I promise to remain open-hearted in hopes to become the best version of myself for us. I promise to remain grateful and thank God often for blessing me with you. I promise to always protect you. I promise to take you to Cancun when you do the dishes. And most importantly, I promise to love you until my last breath.
Do you feel better? You can breathe.
I'm more shaky. A lot.
I practiced this so many times. They say that home is where the heart is, and I didn't understand that until I met you. Whether it was a one-bedroom apartment, an air mattress on the floor, or Austin, my heart remained full. Only you and I know the kind of storms our love has had to weather. And I stand here today, finally seeing the sunlight. I am not sure that a lifetime is long enough for me to enjoy all that you have given me. You're my best friend, my life companion, my nurse, my travel buddy, and my TV binging partner. I remember a simple conversation one day where I asked you to explain your mom to me, because I wanted so desperately to know her. And as you sighed, took big breaths, and held back tears through a smirk describing her light, I had goosebumps from head to toe. You were describing her, and in the same words that I used to describe you. It's what you do to a room whenever you walk in it, the brightest light. I have never seen anything like that. People often ask me what it is that made me fall in love with you. but I can never pinpoint just one. It was your ability to love wholeheartedly, despite the uphill you always walk on. It was the way you fell in love with Cuban coffee, and the way that you twitch when you're falling fast asleep. I am standing here in front of you, and I'm still in awe of how you can put me at ease no matter what. You changed my life in an instant. I have never been quiet about the way I feel about you. And today, I vow to keep loving you loudly and unapologetically. I promise to accompany you to Waffle House because you love it, but just to accompany you, I am not eating there. I vow to never settle on our dreams, and I promise to always bust out some embarrassing dance moves just to keep you laughing. I vow to celebrate our mountaintops and hold you a little tighter when life gets challenging. I promise to always pick flowers for you and kill all the spiders. I will try my best not to get annoyed when you pick at your mascara. I will always be the big spoon, and I'll try to remember what can and can't go in the dryer. I vow to admire your intelligence and make sure your voice is always heard, because it is my favorite sound. I promise to be your peace when you are in pieces, just like you are to me. And above all, I vow to do my best each day to love you more than I did yesterday. Ours is a love story so epic. I have been trying to put into words the way I feel about you now for 5 years. But today I will tell you this. You are all I ever wanted love to be. You are my constant proof of serendipity and my endless answered prayer. Here's to loving what I know of you and trusting what I don't. I pray that my heart will always be the place that you call home. Te amo.
Yeah. I'm better now. Jess is crying.
Security. Security, could you bring those rings up here?
Come right here, baby. Come right here. All right. Want to get a high five?
Thank you, Reeves. I knew they would be safe with you. These rings are symbols of eternity and the unbroken circle of love. Love freely given has no beginning, has no end. As you place the ring on her hand, please say to her,
Thyrene, with this ring I bind my life to yours. It is a symbol of my eternal love and the promise of all of my tomorrows. Don't count this out.
With this ring, I give you my heart. I promise to never count us out and to walk together through life as partners and best friends.
Now, your family and friends have gathered here today to celebrate this special day with you. And there's no doubt you'll be receiving some advice. Looking around, I'm gonna say a lot of advice. But I have the mic so I get to go first. Let your love be stronger than your anger. Remember the wisdom of compromise. It's so much easier to bend than to break. Turn off your phones for at least an hour every day to actually be together and communicate with one another. Make date nights a priority and make time for family dates as well. May the saddest day of your future be no worse than the happiest day of your past. And may your love never fade and you never ever take one another for granted. And in decades to come, may you be found still hand in hand and still thanking God for one another. By the authority granted me by the state of Florida, it is my honor to declare you to be married. You may each kiss your beautiful bride. You can do better than that. Try that again. That's your wife.
This will be the one I've waited for. This will be the one
As the newlyweds approach your row, clasp your confetti to cover them with your well wishes. Wait till they get close to your row.
This will be everlasting love for me.
Every dance is slow, every kiss. round of applause, ladies and gentlemen, right there, Mrs. and Mrs. Falconer. I tell you, family, let me stay right there. Let's get your dad to join on the dance floor for a really special father-daughter dance.
Look at the two of you dancing that way, lost in the moment, in each other's face. So much in love, you're alone in this place, like there's nobody else in the world. I was enough for her not long ago. I was her number one, she told me so, and she still means the world to me, just so you know. So be careful when you hold my girl. Time changes everything, life must go on. I'm not gonna stand in your way. I loved her first, I held her first, and a place in my heart will always be hers. From the first breath she breathed, when she first smiled at me, I knew.
I went and sat down until I got the feeling back in my calf. I ended up with a softball imprint bruise on my leg. Good thing I didn't let that keep us from becoming best friends.
Yes.
We had so many fun memories together. Farrell was my first roommate when I moved off to college. And we had many more mellow festivals. She helped me through my very first time being on an airplane. Not to mention that one time, where me, Farrah, and Darlene were almost on an episode of Cops. Trying to get Farrah's mom's furniture back. Farrah and I share so many great memories. I remember the first time I met Dee in my hotel room when I had to work in Orlando. After we spent hours talking in my hotel room, I knew Farrah had a keeper. I've loved Dee ever since that night. Now Dee and I probably talk more than Farrah and I do. I'm so glad y'all found each other. I hate Farrah's mom, Susan, never got to meet Dee in person. Dee, thank you for welcoming Farrah into y'all's family. I know y'all will treat her like one of y'all's. You were part of our family since the night I met you. I wish you all so much happiness, and I love you both so very much.
From the very first day until the big day, that's today, y'all. She strives to always make sure we're happy, even though our love makes her sick. Dyrena Farrah's biggest fan makes noise for Ashley Sardell!
I've known Farrah for 10 years and Dee for over 5, so I can either share 10 years of embarrassing stories or I tell you too how much I love them. And much to yours, this day, Farrah, I'm going to do the latter. So no embarrassing stories. Now, it doesn't mean that if you don't meet me at the bar later with some tequila shots, I'm not going to tell you about that time that we went to the strip club with Dee. She got so drunk and made me embarrassed by $400. And then we lost her for a whole hour. We didn't know where she was. Or the time that me and Farrah went to Austin for your birthday. Yes! We went to visit Dee, had some drinks, took Farrah jet skiing. She almost took out the entire docks jet skiing after that. Remember that? So meet you later, I'll tell you more stories. Now, Farrah and I met. We both worked at a resort. We talked a few times, got to know each other. I'm like, man, this girl's really cocky, but she seems cool. So I invited her to kind of hang out with us one night. We got closer, decided to ask her to go play pool. This was the first time that I knew I had made a lifelong friend. We had so much in common, but mostly the fact that we worked hard and played even harder. Now we worked in different apartments, but as fate would have it, we ended up working side by side a year later. Wasn't the first time. Fast forward a few years later, we were working in totally different resorts. I had the opportunity to open and manage a water park, and I knew the first call I had to make to do stuff right by my side. I called my partner and cried and joined in the fun. It was a long process, especially when it came to hiring. Remember that? Now on January 20th, 2018, the day we interviewed a beautiful, energetic, motivated UCS students. Now, how do I remember the exact date? I kept your interview questions all this time. Question number 12, Darien, what is your biggest goal in life? Remember what you answered?
No.
I want to find true happiness in every aspect of my life. Aww. G, I think we found it. Aww. Now, of course, she was higher on the spot. As she walked out the door, and Vera said, she's a yes. Please, yeah, she's a yes. So we had a grand opening, long, stressful hours. I remember one night we were building pool racks. Barry came to the office and said, yo, bro, Darien has a girlfriend and she knows how to use a drill. That's the moment I knew. We were both in big trouble. Now, as our love grew, it definitely was not easy. I know Barry had been there some of the hardest years of her life, but together they continued to fight. And when I say the love was tested, that is an understatement. These are literally, there's literally nothing these two cannot handle. Even when you consider the extreme opposites they are. Farrah, a relaxed country girl from a small town in South Carolina. Darien, a loud and crazy girl from Miami. Darien is organized, plans months ahead for any event, and is always prepared and on time. Farrah, we're glad she showed up today on time. Give her a hand for walking down the road. But somehow together they bring out the best in each other. To my D. Thank you for coming into both of our lives and for bringing a spark and light back into Farrah's soul after she dealt with so much pain. You have loved her unconditionally and taken Reeves into your heart even when it was not always easy. I am forever grateful that you continue to fight for her, make her share her feelings, and always make sure her and Reeves never leave the house without breakfast. You and I bonded over song lyrics, inspirational quotes, traveling, and our need to both protect Farrah. I can't wait to continue fighting over who runs each other or more. Farrah. We've been through so much in the last 10 years. I cannot believe I got to stand here and witness the happiest moments that you've been fighting so hard to make. Thank you for always listening, never judging my crazy ideas, and instead being right next to me saying, how can I help? Thank you for allowing me to love Reeves with all my heart, and even spoil him here and there a little bit.
Right.
It has not been an easy ride, but you continue to fight to make him the best little man that he can be. Like you always say, you're always there to pull each other out of the valleys, but this is one mountaintop that I'll never forget. So looking at you and Dee today, it looks like you finally made it to the highest mountain we can make it to, and I can't wait to see what this life brings you both. Life is not going to be easy, and there will always be so many struggles, but tonight, at 5:42, you both said I do. So I hope you remember, when work is tough, you can't wait to get home. Reeves is not doing his homework. I hope you look at the clock at 5:42 and remember the moment you guys had tonight. I thought it was only right to end this speech with a song lyric, because that's how me and Dee always bond. We send each other song lyrics, we send each other quotes. So I wanted to quote one of my favorite philosophers, the Queen Bee Beyonce.
Alright.
So as you raise our glasses, raise your glasses, I don't have one. I would like to toast these brides. And as Beyonce would say, if you're right with the right person, it brings out the best version in yourselves. So cheers, my best friends. I love you both with all my heart.
And now introducing Darien's voice of reason, a super fan of Farrah, and as Jess would call her, the queen of dinner rolls, a love advocate, and the knife of every party. She always knows exactly what to say. So get your tissues ready. Darien's best friend, thanks so much for Cynthia.
Feel like you're the one in this. Cynthia. I'm one of two of Dyrene's very lucky best friends. Well, I've written and rewritten this speech about 100 times because what could I possibly tell Dyrene that she hasn't already heard from me? So I decided to dedicate this speech to three young 19-year-old girls named Cynthia, Dyrene, and Jamie, who thought that life was constantly laughing at them. But who would have known that now they're the ones laughing at life? This is for the girls that have seen each other crying of tears to fit an ocean, hold secrets that will be taken to the grave, and sing country songs at the top of their lungs. Because during the darkest moments of our lives, a sad tune and our best friend's arms were the only thing that have felt safe. And now, those three girls have each found someone to keep their hearts safe. But I want you girls to always remember that the home that watched you grow is right here in this friendship, and the door is always gonna be open. Oh. Dee, I can sit here and tell you I love you in every language that exists, but my favorite one is our language. The one that our hearts speak and only each other understands. There will never be enough words. There will never be enough words to express how immensely proud I am of you. Through every heartbreak, new home, new adventure, and every moment my world feels like it's falling apart, I've watched you soar, and I've watched you conquer, and it's been such a privilege to hold your hand through every single one. I can't imagine a life without my friend. My friend has brought my heart back to life from 1,000 miles away. My friend that doesn't hesitate to put me in my place when I start to wander. My friend that has turned into a sister. Gracias por compartir tu familia conmigo, y gracias a ustedes por la amiga de la alma que me dieron. Ella no sería nadie sin ustedes, y yo nadie sin ella. My words will always be like love for you, never ending. Thank you for seeing me. And to Kara, if angels could walk amongst us, I know that you would be one of them. Thank you for your patience with my very hard-headed friend. You've shown her that love has exceeded all of her expectations. You really are her dream come true. Everyone in this room is so lucky to know I love you, and I know that Dyrene and all of her feelings will always be safe with you. I want you to know that you'll always have a very special place in my heart, along with a few others who have had the pleasure of getting to know and love. The people you surround yourself with are just as amazing as you. I'll never get tired of telling Dyrene that she won the lottery with you. While you two embark on the journey of forever, I want to leave you with a few things that I've learned throughout life. Number one, love is everything. It's the foundation for every other feeling that exists. So through every moment that life presents you, always think of love. Find your strength in love, because within love, you'll find each other. Number two, there will be many problems that you'll have to face. But remember that today, two have become one. So never let a problem be one against the other, but both against the problem. Number three, be better, not bitter. Lead by example and with a heart full of faith, because God doesn't make mistakes, and he knew exactly what he was doing when he led you to each other. Number four, and this one is very important, never forget to call Cynthia. It's an honor to root for your love, to listen to Dyrene when she can't think straight, and to be part of Team Feral all the way and forever.
Yes.
To my best friend, I've always told you that you're the sun, and today I can confirm that you found the sky that makes you shine the brightest. Cheers to love, cheers to the beginning of forever, and cheers to the Falcons.
A loving dog mom of to one of the most present big sis despite the many miles between and the busy schedules. It's always a priority to take care of her baby sister. Give it up for Diana Fungo!
As I began to write this speech, I wanted to try to put into words the true definition of one of the most powerful things in the world, love. Way to hit us off with a bang with a good love.
Mercury's in retrograde.
Mercury's in retrograde. Thank you, John.
Is he okay?
All right, I'm gonna start again. Okay. As I began to write this speech, I wanted to try to put into words the true definition of one of the most powerful things in the world, which is love. The definition of amor. Love is for the sake of loving. It has no desires or needs. It's strong and boundless. And it gives you the feeling of butterflies in your stomach. I know this to be true because I know what falling in love feels like. And that is what Zyrene and Farah are in. They are in love. A blissful, tender, special, head over heels love. It's simple, and it's been such a beautiful thing to witness and a privilege for us to be celebrating that love this evening. Farah, I remember the distinct moment we met. You were being career focused at the water resort, and I was like, wait a minute, Zyrene's on to something. To then a moment where our entire family dies laughing about every chance we get, when you ask my dad about buying a tarp to cover your roof during your first hurricane in Florida. I remember you were nervous to meet me. I know I have very high expectations. It's my baby sister. But I hope you feel the ripple effect of love that you have given my sister coming back to you tenfold from our family. Today, you become Miss Falcon, and I'm so grateful for the love and care you pour into Zyrene. And our family and I couldn't be prouder to call you a sister-in-law. I love you. Zyrene, my baby sister, I've seen you in all of your life stages, from campers to cheerleading, to becoming a UCF Knight, but really go Gators, disrupting the hospitality industry, buying a home, to now today becoming a wife. You've done it all with flair, and being unapologetically yourself and giving all that you have to those in your life with your heart of gold. It's one of the things that I love the most about you. You're glowing tonight, sis. And the love that you have in your heart for Farah radiates across this universe. I can't wait to see your love story continue to blossom and grow. Because where there is love, there is life. To wrap things up, my advice for you both is to, as you enter this exciting chapter of marriage, is to keep falling in love again, every chance you get. Now, let's raise a glass and cheers to the power of love. Felicidades, Zyrene and Farah.
Find out what we made of.
applause here for Diana right there. You know, make some noise for all four of the ladies that came up to say something. Very special, very nice. And I'll tell you what, I like to get all the happy news.
Thank you.
All right, I'm gonna start again.